Thank you, organizers, for this opportunity. So, okay, I'm talking about birds, but I believe birds are closer to humans than chimpanzees. Okay? This is white-rumped munia. This bird has white rump here. And this is a Bengalese finch. You see, you already see this white pigmentation, the patchy pattern. Okay? These guys are the same species. So through this comparative study, I would like to suggest that evolution of some complexity in finches might mirror evolution of language in humans. I will do this first by taking this Tim Bergen's four question strategies. The first question is about evolution. What happened to the song when wild finches are domesticated? And what happened with evolution of complexity? Let's see this again. Okay, this is a wild animal, white-rumped munia. This is a domesticated version of that, Bengalese finch. Very white patchy, and looks like really domesticated. I don't know why. It looks like very wild and very domesticated to be. Now, they have been domesticated for 250 years for reproductive behavior. Actually, they were imported from China to Japan exactly 250 years ago. And since they mature in 3 months or so, there are about 500 generations since then. And morphology changed, pigmentation, plumage changed, as you saw in the photo. But no record describing artificial selection for songs, and many records on selection for reproductive efficiency and white color morph. But nevertheless, songs changed very radically. So, this is a sonogram of Bengalese finch song. This is domesticated version of this white rumped munia. You see, this is time and frequency, and let's hear how does it sound like. Quite complicated. Now, let's hear the white rumped munia song. Okay, I did it. You see here, looks like complicated, but actually it's repetition of same sequences like this. Here, looks like complicated, and it's really complicated. When I make a transition diagram, Bengalese finch song is like this. It's really complicated with many loops and many going back arrows like this. And white rumped munia song is basically simple linear repetition. Okay? Now, next is about development. Some differences between the wild and the domesticated finches are due to cultural difference or difference stems from innate predispositions. This is a question. So, we did a cross-fostering experiment. We exchanged eggs from Bengalese to munia, eggs from munia to Bengalese like this, and we examined whether they can learn songs. The answer is Bengalese finches can basically learn munia songs, but munias have difficulty. Like in this case, this is a Bengalese finch father song. It's going like something like this. And this is a Bengalese finch son song. It's similar. But this is a munia fostered to this Bengalese finch. You see that they can do this, but they cannot do this. They cannot do this, right? So, the learnability is wider in Bengalese. And this is just a schematic diagram of this behavioral complexity and the individuals. Bengalese finches have wider range of learnability. And when they are tutored with complex songs, they can learn. When they are tutored with simple songs like white-rumped munias, they can still learn. Munias have narrower learnability. When they are tutored by a simple song, they can learn. But when they are tutored by complex song, they will make it simple. So this is what's going on. Then we did this kind of multi-tutor study in which we put 10 males, 11 females in a large flight cage. And in case of Bengalese finches, 26 out of 32 chicks reared under this condition learned songs from multiple 2 to 4 tutors. In case of white-rumped Munias, in the same setting, Munias learned only from their father. This is a case of Bengalese finch. This is a second generation. And this is actually the father of this person, this guy. And this bird is learned here. But in addition to this bird, this chick learned from other guys like this one here and these ones here. So by learning from multiple tutors, Bengalese finches can make multi-branch songs like this, but Munias learn only from father. Next is about mechanisms. Song differences between the wild and the domesticated finches are due partially to differences stemming from innate predispositions. Then, what kind of predispositions are these, is a question. This is a volumetric comparison of the song control brain nuclei. These are four brain song control nuclei in Bengalese finches and Munias. This is actually the basal ganglia. This is HVC. This is a higher vocal center. And this is a motor area to control vocalizations. You see that Munias are smaller. Bengalese are larger. HVC, RA, and area X. So the song-related brain nuclei are larger in Bengalese finches, domesticated strain. We also compared neurotransmitters expressed in several song-related areas, like these are several different glutamate receptors. Okay, when there are differences, it's always like Bengalese have higher expression of these plasticity-related transmitters. The final question is about function. Song differences between the wild and domesticated finches are due partially to differences stems from innate predisposition that is related with brain plasticity. Then, what caused these differences? One factor may be sexual selection. So we asked females. Females are ones, they have to listen to the song and decide which ones to mate. So we set up this kind of apparatus. We put nesting material like this, and female would carry nesting materials into this nest pot. We stimulated female either by simple song or complex song. These we edited based on one real song. We made simple song or complex syntax song. The syllables included in simple song and the complex songs are the same. Nevertheless, when stimulated by complex song, birds, female birds carried like 40 nesting materials a day, every day, after 2 weeks or so. And they will keep carrying this much. But when stimulated with simple or no sound at all, they did not carry as much as when they are stimulated by complex ones. And body size and song duration correlate. And this is a principal component of body mass and size in male Bengalese finches. And this is song bout duration. How long does the song continues? So this correlate. Therefore, females can guess whether the guy is well made, steadily made or not by listening to the song. So by mating with a guy singing complex song, female get more healthy kids. So 4 questions now reveal that Bengalese finches and white-rumped Munias The same species only separated for 250 years, but some complexity evolved in Bengalese finches. And Munias are narrowly focused to learn Munia songs, while Bengalese have open learnability. Bengalese finches have neuroanatomical characteristics for song complexity that are lacking in white-rumped Munias. Song complexity evolved presumably because of indirect female choice of song complexity and their relaxed domesticated environment. Okay, so we're good. Now, I'm going to focus on non-song factors, socio-emotional factors of domestication in these finches. Birds, okay, in a bird cage, this is a food cup, this is a water cup. Okay, what we did is we put some falling object in the food cup to see how long does it take for birds to come back to eat. They are very careful animals, so even by just exchanging food cup, it would take some time for Munias to come to eat, but Bengalese finches comes immediately to eat. If you put novel object in the food cup, takes some time for Bengalese, but Munias never came. We stopped the experiment here because they don't come. And if they don't come, they got too hungry. So next is measuring aggressiveness. We hold a bird, then we attack the bird with this stick. Actually, this stick has a piezoelectric sensor to measure the force of a bite. Okay, we stimulated birds 5 times like this. Okay, and white-rumped Munia, out of 5 times, they in average bite 4 times. Bengalese does bite 1.5 times or so. So Munias bite more. And Bengalese are less stressed. This is about as you see. This is a time of day. Okay, sorry. This is a time of day, and this is fecal corticosterone concentration. And white-rumped Munias and Bengalese, you see, it's always twice as high in white-rumped Munias. So, socio-emotional factors. Munias are more xenophobic, aggressive, and stressed than Bengalese finches. These factors account for some of the differences in song complexity. Neophilia promotes learning from multiple tutors, as you saw in Bengalese finches. Aggressiveness, more emphasis on intra-sex competition than on intersex selection, because aggressiveness tends to result in male-male competition rather than female choice. And stress inhibits learning in general. So let's link this to human language. Relaxation and sexual selection as driving force for signal competition, complexity. And we have this wild white-rumped Munias singing simple song, more stressed, more aggressive. And this is a domesticated Bengalese finches singing more complex song, larger brain nuclei, and more relaxed. And we have this random chimpanzee here, and we have Mr. Chairman here. So, sexual speculation, human language as a product of self-domestication. Because humans have fewer predators, sexual selection for signal complexity is promoted. Because human, as now, probably has lower stress than the ancient humans, that I'm not too sure actually, but will enhance learning. And degeneration of aggressiveness will lead to selection for sociable traits. And social and signal complexity will come like this, through this process. It goes to compositional use of plastic vocal tokens. So I hope I convinced you that learning about finches is more fruitful than learning about chimpanzees. And thank you very much for listening.